Okay, so this was doing digital inking within Photoshop, and the important thing is I kept it on its own layer. And obviously I have a lot more to do, but I'm going to show you how I can then take this and turn it into a vector. So the way to do that is to isolate it so it's just on its own, and then say file, save a copy. And then it actually doesn't matter if you save it as a JPEG or as a PNG. But I call these test files. I don't give them my name because this is not something you would submit. This is something you move between programs. So I'm going to call this my raster line art. And it's at a pretty high resolution, right? So if I open up that raster line art, it should look clean. I should have to zoom in quite a bit before I see those pixels. So make sure I'm at 8 by 8 inches by 350 pixels per inch. That's the minimum. All right. So if when you ink it, you think that that's a good, interesting silhouette, then you're good to go. But if you think that your sketch could have a more interesting proportion or silhouette, this is what I recommend in your raster program when you're cleaning it up. Duplicate it, hit Command T, and then play with distort, right? Play with warp, try to figure out your proportions. If I wanted to make the head even bigger, that's kind of fun. That's a pretty big difference. And I kind of like that better. So you want to mess with that in the sketch phase before you take all this time to ink it, right? Make sure the silhouette's interesting, the proportions are interesting. Now, what do you do with those inks once you've saved them? I've just saved them as a JPEG here, and that JPEG is a pretty good size, right? Pretty good resolution, 8 by 8 by 350. Now what I do is I open up that JPEG in Adobe Illustrator, in our vector program. I don't know why I have two versions of Adobe Illustrator 2024. IT is filling up my computer. But I'm going to open it up. Really doesn't matter what version you use. It's going to come in. First thing I'm going to do is click on it, hold down Shift, and shrink it to fit onto the artboard. Again, doesn't matter for resolution, just matters for clarity. Then I am going to convert this into vector line art. So pretend this looked really good because I cleaned it up. It all looks good. What I now do is I click on it with the large selection tool, top tool, and then I click on properties. And then I scroll down past all their new AI tools, which you're not allowed to use for this, because it's all about making one that we control, right? And I'm going to click on Image Trace. Image Trace is magical. When you click on it, it's going to give you these different options. You're going to click on Black and White Logo. That's the one I'm always going to direct you to, because Image Trace works best as just black shapes, right? So Black and White Logo. The problem is that's not black. It's not black shape logo. It's black and white. So then you got to click on the options here to get to more options for that tracing. And then you have to click on advanced to get more options in the options. So this is professional use. And you'll see all of these dials, just like an adjustment layer that you can play with. You want to make sure that it's clicked on preview so you can see what it's doing. And then you want to click this option, which is ignore color. So I'm going to show you what this does by pushing it off the artboard. When you ignore color, it's going to ignore the white. So it doesn't make white shape vectors. It only makes black shape vectors. And even though it's not a vector yet, it's showing me what the vector would be if I were to hit expand at this point. So how can I control how it, this is called vectorizing. I can control it by using the threshold. The narrower the threshold, the thinner the lines will be. The larger the threshold, the bulkier the lines will be. I can change it by playing with the paths. The fewer paths, the smoother the lines would be, then maybe some of my shapes will get oversimplified. The more paths, the more complex my shapes will be, but then it might have a little bit more waviness to it. The corners, the fewer corners, the smoother it will be. The more corners, the more detailed. And then noise. I don't have a lot of noise in mind. Noise are like little dots that might have been like fragments on the scanner or something that you didn't clean up. But you can set the noise to not allow any image below 95 pixels to be turned into a vector, right? Once you're happy with all of that, then you hit expand at the bottom of your properties. And that then converts it to a vector. So if you use your small selection tool, you'll see all of those anchor points. And then what happens often, especially when you do raster inking or hand inking, is you'll have these little overflows, even sometimes when you do vector inking. So how do we clean that up? We use the pencil tool. The good old pencil tool, we can set it to be smoother, and then it's like magic scissors, right? And we can clean up these corners. And we can make everything look as good and as clean as we want. I can use the smooth tool. Everything we learned with our logo project, we could use to improve our line art. And that's today's job, to try to get good black line art of whatever our illustration idea is. And I did see some hands up. I'll come around and help with that. Whoops. All right, so I just showed you how you bring something in, raster line art, from somewhere like Procreate, from somewhere like Clip Studio Paint, from somewhere like Paint Toolsy, from somewhere like Photoshop, into Illustrator and use image trace to turn it into a vector. But there is a better way, in my opinion. And that better way is to use this tool in Illustrator, which is called the Blob Brush. So instead of digital inking in Photoshop, all I would do for this method is to make my sketch and clean it up in Photoshop, and then save my sketch onion skinned as it is as my refined sketch that I'm going to turn in for my project. And this is for assignment 5. All right, so if I have my refined sketch, I can just save that as a JPEG. To do that, I need to save a copy, save as a JPEG to the desktop. That's the first thing that goes into Canvas to acknowledge the deadline, right? First requirement. Then I can close Photoshop. I don't need it at all anymore. But remember what I used it for. I used it to play with the proportions and to get it so the silhouette was what I wanted. Now I'm in Illustrator and I could drag and drop that JPEG on, or I can do what we did for our logo and just take my sketch, my JPEG sketch, and say open it with Illustrator. Then Illustrator will open up and it will place it. And then the first thing I do is I use my large selection tool and I make it as big as I can, holding shift on the artboard. So I make use of my screen pixels, right? And I go to layers, and if I needed to, if it was too dark, I could double click the layer and I could dim it. I could onion skin it even more. And then I want you to lock that layer and make a new organizational layer on top so you can easily turn your sketch off at any time. And in this layer 2, that's where I'm going to do my vector line art. So just like doing it in Photoshop, I want to set my defaults to so it's a solid black fill. So to do that, I choose solid black on this top window and I have an empty stroke. Next, what I do is I click on the paintbrush tool, open it up. You might have the pencil tool on. I have the smooth tool on. That's just what I last used. And you're going to find the blob brush tool. The shortcut for that, if it's on something else, is Shift B. So the blob brush. The blob brush is different than the brush tool because the brush tool modifies strokes. The blob brush makes full outline paths, which is wonderful. Let's see what it actually says about it in the new version. Draw filled shapes that can merge with others of the same color. That is perfect for digital inking. So what does that mean? Just like the pencil tool, if I double click it and I have my tablet, I can set it to be more smooth than it is accurate, which is going to help. I'm going to set it to be incredibly smooth. See how that works. And then I can set the size, and then I can set it to be pressure sensitive, which I want to do. And I want to set the variation to be the same as the size, which means it will allow me, and you can define those any way you want, but to go from this big to this tiny, all with one brush, and then it will clean it up for me. But when I do a circle in this, unlike in Photoshop, it will do it right away because vectors process a lot faster than pixels at high resolution. So it will be a lot more like using a real ink pen. And I might decide to make it just a little bit smaller. Remember, these are point sizes, not pixel sizes, because we're in Illustrator. And now I just start to ink. And it's like a blob of ink that every time I add to it, it all merges together into one path. Like a blob of ink, which is incredibly helpful. And I'm a little bit shaky, but then it will smooth it out for me. And if I'm doing something at a weird angle, I can use the tool underneath the magnifying glass, this rotate tool, and use my space bar to move around it. I can zoom in, I can zoom out. And we don't need our vectors to be as refined as they were for our logos. So we might have a lot more detail, but we want to feel like we have full control of them. And full control of this line art. And don't be too obsessive about it, because vectors can also, you'll have full control of the anchor points later, right? So if you want to redraw it, you can use the pencil tool. You can fix it up. Also, because they're vectors, they're clean at any size, right? So if I want to do something like this, it's a really light touch, and I keep messing up. I'm going to maybe zoom out a little bit, make my brush a little bit smaller just by double-clicking, taking down the size. And it will clean it up, right? If then I want to clean that up, I can just hold down, use the small selection tool, click on it so I see the anchor points, use my pencil tool like magic scissors, right, which I can also set to be smoother. Fix those outlines. And then once I have a shape I like, use the large selection tool and then copy it and paste it. And I can start to shrink them down a little bit. I still want it to look hand done. Copy it, paste it. Shrink it down a little bit. And that will look really, really uniform. Copy it, paste it. So you can hand ink everything, or you can use what you know of compositing, right, and apply it to these vector shapes. Whoops. I just keep hitting return like it's a transform box. You don't need to. So Command-Z or cancel. And then